Chapter 9, Hidden in Plain Sight. Okay, why do Roman soldiers have firearms? Jack, explain it, and where did you get that leather coat and a hat that eerily looks like mine? I stepped towards him until a gun clicked right at my head. I turned my head to see it was the mysterious man from the manger scene before, and I thought I saw him by the garden room as well. Allow me to introduce Carlos Mateo, an archaeologist who has been trying to track down the manger. Sorry, Willie. I told you I was here just taking a few shots. It just turned out to be not the ones with a camera. So if you would not mind handing over the manger. Did you not hear the tyrant I went on?
Then at least hand over the poem, Mateo said.
Why should I? You or Jack probably have no idea how to use it.
Ah, but I do.
Jack then raised his hand and Samantha walked over to him.
Samantha? Really?
I frankly was just as confused as Monica was. She seemed so innocent, but she tricked us all.
It's always the ones that you don't believe.
Now, I'll make a deal with you, Willie old boy. I will let you assist in the discovery and gaze upon the manger, but then the boys here will kill you when you die.
Jack, why?
Look, Willie, I've been on the bad side since kindergarten. All that snooping around St. Jane's, the close calls, the fascination with treasure hunting, it should make sense. Sam here was researching the crib and I decided to bring her on board. Bribed the help of Carlos here and there you go.
My name's Jack Roberts. The job is in the name.
But why do you want to do it? Michael asked. Flynn or Samantha here didn't tell you the rest of the legend. The manger holds a power where it can turn any humble object into something priceless. The simplest of rusty nails into one that is precious and shines.
Don't you think that would get a little old? Too many riches? Nicholas questioned.
The humblest of beds held the most important of people. Turning everyday objects into pieces of wealth? Boring?
Ha! I think not.
Now open the scroll. Against mine, and pretty much everyone else's will, we opened the scroll. I might add at this point the stable cast was taking a break and the groups had stopped for now. We laid it out on the ground and all surrounded it.
Flynn, would you like to do the honors?
No, it's your story.
That's the first honest thing he said to me.
Well, let's see here. The Carol of the Crib is about the bed for one who is not whining. No tears were shed for...
The stars are brightly shining, Lana added.
She bent down and wrote the phrase in, and the words glowed.
Here we go again with the glowing.
Okay, now. It kept him warm, it kept him safe. Away from danger.
Away in a manger, Michael said.
He wrote the lyric in. And more glowing.
Nice.
Future wood, some fear and jeer. The crib's wood
came upon a midnight clear, Nicholas said, finishing.
Lyric, glow. A king who wore no robe or crown, for he was born in
a little town,
Monica brought up. You know what happens.
Animals first saw the babe of might, but...
I got it. Shepherds quake at the sight, Jack said. He then came forward and wrote it in.
Almost there. Kings then came, brought no gems, so that...
Christ was born in Bethlehem, Samantha said softly.
All right. The bed you seek of the one who reconciled will be...
Round young virgin, mother and child.
Flynn spoke up. He filled in the line and we all looked at the stable. Jack and his group all looked at the hay bale that Mary was previously sitting on and then down at the manger that was there.
Hidden in plain sight.
He went over a rope and into the stable and knelt down at the manger. We could hear one of the other scenes with menacing music playing. He reached into the manger and let some of the hay slip through his fingers. He then directed the Roman guards to pick it up. As he left and the soldiers went in, he kept scratching his hand. Eventually, he realized a rash had developed and started going up his arm.
I must be allergic to hay. I don't think God likes you going through his bed. The rash then spread all the way to Jack's face, and I swear he was screaming so loud that the entire town could hear him. Willie? Sorry, Jack. It was nice to see you again, though, old friend. Jack then collapsed, and he was completely red. The guards all collapsed as well. Mateo seemed puzzled. A lot of us were. He grabbed Samantha, and they climbed on horseback and rode off through the living nativity.